It's time for another episode of Instant Noodle Recipe Time. This is the show where I show you what to do with your instant noodles. And today we've got something really interesting and instant. This is Best Wok Corn Bihun. It's hot and spicy flavor. These are corn vermicelli. It's vermicelli made from corn. Indeed, look at that. That's what it looks like. Really light, thin. And what's different about this than, at least from what I've found, from rice vermicelli, this stuff doesn't end up so dry. And that's kind of a nice aspect to it. The other stuff, like rice vermicelli, ends up, as I just said, kind of dry. So this is like a combination of sweet potato noodle or sweet potato vermicelli and rice vermicelli. The sweet potato vermicelli is super, super mushy and gunky, and this isn't. This is more, it's like rice vermicelli that's more moist. I don't know how to put it other than that, but it's good. It's actually really good. And I'm pretty sure this pack is gluten-free. It's also low-cal. Doesn't it say on here? I know it does. I think it's like 250 calories or something like that. But it's a decent meager ring. Their stuff is good. I really enjoy Best Wok products. Ding! I do. Nice folks. Very nice people. Someday to Indonesia I will go. That would be fun. Well, I hope everybody's having a good day today. If not, then fix that immediately. Not having a good day really rubs me the wrong way. So don't do that. Have a good day. Yeah. Do it. Oh, I could use the red plate, but the red plate's too reflective. I was thinking red plate for a second there, but I'm gonna use this one. This one's a really trippy, kind of deep dish. Vermicelli. Look at that. All fluffy like rice. Pretty neat. And this is the third one I'm doing this morning. 9:24 in the a.m. here in beautiful downtown Kenmore, Washington, where courtesy is contagious. Some might say where courtesy goes to die, but you know, hopefully it won't. I think the deal is if you name a give a place like a title that sounds like, oh, it's going to be so nice and peaceful and wonderful and everybody's going to be good, they won't be. Like, if you have a kid, don't name them happiness. But that's just like dooming them to sadness. I don't know. Things don't seem to work out the way that people want them to when it comes to nomenclature, I guess. When I was growing up, there was a guy I knew. His name was Justice. And he was a real jerk. And you know where he ended up? Learning all about Justice. Too bad, too. But, you know, it could have been a contender, but I don't think that worked out so well. Hopefully, everybody everywhere is having a great day. I know I am. I am almost done. Here is noodle. Let's give it a try. So it's sweet and it's spicy. Groovetacular. I will say I think I like the original better, but this certainly is good. You know me, I like my spicy, but I think it detracts from the... So this vermicelli does have a hint of a taste of corn, and I kind of like that aspect of it. And you kind of get more of a feel of that in the original. It is kind of difficult to plate, I will say that. You're just skating around here, being a happy egg. Thank you, sir.
Hi.
There's that. We'll put a little bit of that on. If you end up finding this, I highly recommend you give it a try, because it's something new and different and good, which I recommend. Those attributes, yes. Best Walk for sending this stuff over. It's been a little while, but I wanted to like save this one for the right day, and today was it. So there you go. So the next one I'm doing is this. Samyang Foods Vegetasty Noodle Soup. It's vegan friendly, and I got some things to say about this one. So yeah, catch it on the next episode. This has been Hans the Ramen Raider wishing you enjoyment of your noodles each and every day. Have a good one. Bye-bye. The Ramen Raider coming at you with another episode of his noodle recipe time. The show that I show you what to do with your instant noodle. This is Vegetasty from Samyang Foods. Comes with a sachet that you put in right now, and it'll take 4 minutes. So yeah, welcome to the noodle rave. Yeah, made in South Korea. This is made, distributed by Samyang USA on Wilshire, down in beautiful Los Angeles, California. Actually, what am I talking about? That's where the Dodgers are at. Bad place, bad place. We're not Dodgers fans here, we're Giants fans. Everybody likes the Dodgers. Not us. So what's happening? Yep, this is the last one, and I'm gonna go step out. Yeah, it's gonna be a good day. It is. People have been saying lately that I look like Walter White. I don't think so. And luckily, the reason I'm bald, not because of some kind of horrible discovery of illness. No, it's because I'm losing my hair. And instead of spending like $40,000 to put hair on my head. Never had to pay for it before. I decided to pay like $26, get a little buzzer, and now I'm smooth. So I like that. It's comfortable in the summer too. Next week we've got an excessive heat warning. We're looking at 4 days in a row of 90s and above, which might not sound like a lot, especially to my buddy Stumpy from North Little Rock, because he's dealing with, or has dealt with, he had like 2 weeks of upper 90s, and then the humidity made it feel like it was like 110. That's vicious. Ugh. He refused to acclimate, though. I told him, dude, go do some sunbathing, get out in it a little bit. No, no. His answer to it was sleep all day and then be up all night. It's just like, how do you sleep all day? It's too hot. He's got air conditioning, but I guess it just doesn't work all that wonderfully. That's what happens. What bowl am I using for this? Oh, that one? Yeah, we can do that. It's a very basic bowl. Very, very basic. But sometimes that one works the best. Like yesterday, I did a miso cup noodle from Germany, and I used the ultra basic bowl, and it was one of my favorite images of the day. So yeah, we'll give the basic bowl another moment in the sun. Shout out to my buddy Jamie. He's traveling abroad out of the house in the UK right now, in strange places, doing strange things on buses at 2 a.m. I don't know what's going on there. It sounds strange, but and yeah, it is Sunday morning. Sunday morning wouldn't guarantee that Monday there would be 90 degree weather. But we'll see. I kind of like it. It kind of feels like a challenge. The challenge, you know? I like to be challenged by weather. I do a pushback. The only thing I can't handle is freezing rain. If that happens, all bets are off. I'm not going to break my neck walking on a sheet of ice. I tried. I really, really tried. Even wearing basically these like yak track things. Well, mine are called snow tracks, but they're the same thing. Just like rubber over, just like shoe covers that have spikes on the bottom. I couldn't even walk wearing those. It's like, forget it. Here's our noodle. Oh yeah. So they're calling this veggie tasty. It used to be called 60 types of ingredients. It was also called savory vegetable. And just for some reason, for going into the US market or the Western market, they have to keep changing the name for it. Why? And see, that's really, 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 really good. As far as a vegetable instant noodle, especially one from made in South Korea, the flavors that it's imparting are quite excellent. Now, why can't they sell it? It's the way it looks. Not the in a product, but look at this. I think they like the background a lot, and I think that's what needs to change, not the name. Maybe a picture of a farm life in the background, in the foreground, a couple hands, just such large, powerful hands, holding a basket of vegetables, people smiling, good times, simple pleasures, vegetable delight. I don't know, something like that. I think where it's at right now, it just needs a little more basicness, because I think that is the audience who's looking for something like this. It's got a nice big endorsed by the vegan people thing on it, and that's great. But I think the whole thing needs to be scrubbed of the imagery. And I think it needs to be made kind of retro, kind of old-timey. That's my take on it. You'd be like, why would you even bother? They're not going to listen to you. They might not. But I've had companies ask my opinion on product naming for Western markets many times, which is honestly quite humbling and really neat. I think it's cool. If you're looking for help with a name for an instant noodle, for over here, I'll give you my opinion. Am I gonna sell you more noodles that way? I don't know, but I will definitely give you my educated opinion, my wife's educated opinion as well. She's pretty smart about these things also, you know?
My wife knows everything.
could do something like that. You could like totally flip the script and just like turn it into like,
you've never tasted life like this. Don't kill any animals. Kill the vegetables with your teeth.
I don't know. I remember I got in trouble when I was a kid because I was like, you know, some people don't like to eat meat because it's bad for the animals, but I feel bad for the corn. My dad, like, got all ticked off about that. Like, I feel bad for the corn, Dad.
Shut up and eat your corn.
I'd probably say the same thing. Anyways, this has been Hans the Ramen Raider wishing you enjoyment of your noodles each and every day. If you find this one, for God's sake, try it. It's really good, and it deserves its place in the sun. Like, subscribe, really helps me out, helps people end up finding the channel, finding out more about instant noodles and how to prepare them in a nicer way. And, yeah, enjoy your noodles each and every day, have a good one, and bye-bye.